So hello everyone, and welcome to the first joined up webinar of the Food and Culture Connection COP. So we are very glad to have such a large attendance today, and we are around 15-17 people attending the webinar. So I would ask you all to do an effort, an organizational effort, to raise your hands, to ask for to make your contributions and so on. And we have quite a dense agenda, which is essentially which hasn't changed much from what we've sent over earlier. I don't know, Giovanni, if we could share the outline of the day, maybe on the web screen.
Yes, it is on the screen. Is not you can see?
Okay, yes, now I have it as well. So Giovanni will make an introduction on the theme of the webinar, which is local food branding, how we do guarantee true local food. And the discussion will revolve around three main questions that we are aimed to answer. Why and how to set rules about true local food, how to signal this local origin of food on the market, and how to guarantee consumers about the local origin of food. Then we are very keen to show you some interviews we've made to some local producers in the province of Lucca and Pisa as well. And then after this first section, we are going to give time for general discussion about the themes that we have touched upon. In the end, we'll have wrap up and conclusions and final remarks. So let's stick to the agenda. And Giovanni.
Okay.
Floor is yours.
Okay. Thank you, Sabrina. Thank you all. Good morning. We are working here together with Andrea on the issue of local food and how to signal local food on the market. So we have prepared this short presentation in order to underline some points and to highlight some issues about this theme of local, how to signal local food on the market. So the first issue is why we have to think about branding local food, because normally local food is sold on short food chains, and in this kind of chains, farmers and consumers are directly interacting, following in general domestic quality conventions. So the exchanges are based on direct knowledge and trust. But we are also observing a strong growth of interest in local food. So this interest is increasing the complexity in local food chains. So there is an increase in demand, and this increase in demand attracts a new form of supply. So there is a professionalization and massification of local food supply on local markets. There are also new actors that enter in local food business, and in some cases are specialized farmers, but there are also some professional purchasers that are interested in buying local food, for example, public procurement, and also supermarkets. Then there are also new forms of intermediation between supply and demand. For example, there is this initiative born in France and now spreading all around Europe, this is the Rouge Kiwi. I don't know if you know, this is a new form of intermediation connecting local and local consumer and local producers. So what we observe is an higher heterogeneity in local quality characteristic of food. So this situation, these trends are generating an information asymmetry and also room for opportunistic behavior in local food markets. So in this sense, in some situation, domestic quality conventions are not well working. So people, actors in local food systems are thinking about how to formal signal the quality of the local food. The other general issue is what is branding? Because branding is not just a matter of putting a label on a product, but we have to conceptualize branding as a process with three main steps. The first one is the definition on the what is the content that should be signaled through the brand. So setting up common rules about local. Then there is a second step is to build a common quality brand and collective initiatives in order to support the brand on the market. And the third step is to set up some form of guarantee about the content of the brand. That is, in this case, this specific case, the meaning of local and the true local food. So we highlight three main questions, and we also I've tried to give an answer to this question by means of the interviews we made to the three local food initiatives in Lucca area and Pisa area. And the first question is why and how to set rules about true local food. The issues are the main issue is how do we define a local? Because as you know, there is a many works in literature discussing and debating on the real meaning of local in food systems. And there are also many controversies in terms of what different categories of actors in local food system perceive and communicate as local. So the first big question is if local is only a matter of provenance of food, independently from what is cultivated, what is produced, and the way the food is produced, or if local is also express also a link to some local specific sources and a specific terroir. So we can speak about local food and where only the provenance matter, but we can speak also about origin food, where local food have some specific characteristic due to the provenance of food and to the way the food is produced in the local area. And in this main area, in this main issue, there are other specific issues. For example, what is the place of local agrobiodiversity in defining local food? Another specific issue could be the place of organic, or in general, the place of traditional farming systems that characterize in some situation local food. And for example, a food GMO cultivated closer to the place of consumption can be considered as local, independently on the technology producer use for this production process or not. Then there is other issues that complexify the issue of local when we speak about processed food with many ingredients, many raw materials entering the process, or when we speak about traditional recipes. In this case, what is local? Is only the recipe, or is also the provenance or the origin of food, of raw materials, is important in defining this local processed food and local traditional recipes. So this is about the so in this considering all these, it is important to set some rules about what is a true local food. It's obvious that there is not only one true definition of local food, but the issue is that local actors have to agree on a definition of local food. So rules can play many functions. First of all, they can help to manage unfair competition in order to avoid free riding, also free riding between producers inside the same local system. Then another function of definition of rules is that the process aiming at defining rules push producers to reflect on and to define a shared concept of local food, not only for producers but also for consumers. So defining rules can act also as an internal quality convention among consumers and producers. Then there is another function, is communicating, and then also regulating. That is, for example, defining rules is the basis in order to give rights, for example, of use of collective quality labels, or give right to access to some marketing channel, for example, public procurement, competing public procurement, or access farmer markets. So the issue is also how to define rules, because rule setting process are of paramount relevance in this process. So the room of participative techniques in order to define what is local. And also which can be the role of local public authorities in helping this process of setting up rules. The second question is how to signal the local origin of food on the market. We know that local is a credence attribute, so an attribute that can generate information asymmetry and opportunistic dialogue, as we said before. So there is a need to provide a clear and credible signal to customers and consumers as regard the provenance, origin, and in general, quality characteristic linked to provenance and origin of food. So in this sense, branding can be considered as a partial substitute of the two main traditional forms of guarantee on local food market, that is a substitute of direct relationships that helps producers to signal the local attribute the consumer to check it, because the first experience in local food marketing channels were based on this kind of direct relationship between consumers and producers. And the other way that brand can in some sense substitute is the long-term relation that is established between producer and consumers that share in many cases some personal values and so create trust on the way by means of these long-term relations. Another issue is related to collective branding. We focus mainly on collective branding because for sure also individual producers can elaborate brands in order to guarantee or to signal the local characteristic of their food. Collective branding is also a matter of technical tools. So we have, for example, some legal tools such as collective trademarks and also geographical collective trademarks that are a specific special category of collective trademarks in the general figure of collective trademark. And these collective trademarks can cover single products, for example, this Gran Prato bread in 0 miles in an area close to Firenze, or also can cover a basket of products, or also basket of products and services. But collective branding can also act as a way of accreditation of some selling points, for example, farmer markets, such as in this case in Lucca or the farmers market of Campagna Amica, this farmer association that we will present after. And also, for example, collective branding can also be used in order to as a quality seal on the menu of restaurants, such in this case, menu 0 miles, or also in order to signal the accreditation of restaurants that are engaged in supporting local producers. That is, as in this case of Vetrina Toscana, that is an initiative by Tuscany region in order to accreditate restaurants engaged in this kind of activities. So there is a wide coverage of collective branding, not only on products, but also on products and services related to these products, or on a way of sell the products, such as in the farmer market case. The third point, on how to signal, we have another issue that is, for sure, collective branding generate costs and benefits, both for firms, for consumers, and also for the whole local system. So to be able to assess these costs and benefits is an issue of great importance. In some cases, branding of local is also a way to integrate food, culture, and tourism, such as in these cases we put the label on the bottom of the slide. And then what is important to take in consideration is that branding needs some form of organization, collective organization, and the elaboration of specific governance systems. A brand is not only a label, but is also a system of governance, a collective organization able to drive the process and also to check, to guarantee the quality of the product sold under the label. And then also in this case, there is the role of public bodies. In some of these cases, for example, Qualità Alto Adige is not in Tuscany, but is a case where a region is the activator of this brand covering a wide range of quality products in a region in North Italy. Everything at Toscana we see before. The third issue is how to guarantee purchasers on the local origin of food in an effective way. This means a way that is able to fit to the characteristics of local actors. So in general, there is a need now in the current evolution of local food system, there is a need to provide consumers a credible guarantee as regards the quality and the local origin of their products. So clear that there are many systems of give guarantee. Guarantee can be based on personal assurance, on personal trust of actors involved in an exchange, but there is also the other side of the problem is to elaborate systems of formal certifications. And it's clear that to compare these different kinds of guarantee is very important in order to identify the better one, considering the specific characteristics of the local system or the producers involved in the system. We have, as you know, different typology of certification, first party, second party, and third party certification. Third party certification is the better one in terms of level of guarantee, because there is a fully independent assessment declaring that some specific requirements pertaining to a product, personal process have been met. So in this case, there is a professional certifier, the professional certification body, but is also the costs and the degree of formalization of the guarantee system is quite high. So this very often this is not well fitting the characteristics of local food systems. So when we speak about guarantee systems for small local food system, we have to think about some specific characteristics. That is, for example, they have to be simple and understandable to operators, to actors, to producers, and also to consumers. In some sense, they are also to be able to include multiple objects of certification. So not only the provenance, but also, for example, environment, the respect of environment, or organic, or other, other aspects, specific quality attributes. Then they have to be cheap, in particular in order to allow for small operators to access this kind of certification system, easy to communicate to consumers, and also in some sense participatory, in order to give room not only to formal control, but also to dialogue and in this sense interaction in between consumers and producers can be a good opportunity in order to give some forms of group certification and develop internal control system for guarantee the local characteristics of food. So there are many emerging tools that try to involve producers and consumers in formal guarantee of specific qualities of products. So the issue is how to give a formal guarantee following not strong formal way of guarantee, of certification. And in this sense, participatory guarantee systems are very interesting. So only some insights about what is a participatory guarantee system. Perhaps you know this approach to certification is developed by FOAM in the organic arena, and they are defined by FOAM as systems that are locally focused on specific quality assurance. So they certify producers based on active participation of different stakeholders involved in the supply chains, and they are built on a foundation of trust, social network, and knowledge exchange. So not only on technical capacities, but also to interaction and trust. So in general, this kind of participatory guarantee system are based on the direct involvement of producers, normally small producers, small farmers, organized in a producer group, and collaborating with other purchasers or governmental agencies or also scientists in order to build intergroup associations able to assure consumers about specific quality characteristics of food. So some of the quality labels, brands we have presented before are based on this kind of participatory guarantee systems. So this is the last slide of the presentation. And now, I don't know, we can have some time in order to questions or remarks or considerations. Then we will present the three case studies Marina told before.
Are there any burning questions or comments?
Hi, this is Sandra. Can I ask a question?
Yeah, hello, Sandra.
Thanks, Giovanni. Do you have some estimations or knowledge what are real benefits and outcomes of local branding? I don't know if there are some studies. Do they really work? What has been reached? Do they meet expectations of people, producers who engage in them?
We have made some investigations, but the issue is that we can identify different benefits and costs. We are now working on a short guide on that, and we hope we can share with you this short guide, very practical guide, in order to identify in the categories. But then the stakeholders, the actors, have to analyze the cost and benefits in the specific situation, because cost and benefits are strongly dependent on the characteristic of the food, of the product, on the local situation, on the typology of the chain, and so the answer is no in a systematic way.
Yeah, actually we are working, it's Andrea Marescotti speaking. We are working mostly on geographical indications, not just in Europe, in the European Union, but in other countries of the world. And we have carried out some studies about costs and benefits from having and using the PDO-FPGI, but they are quite specific studies, not comprehensive ones. There are some studies about geographical indications carried out at European Union level through case studies, and benefits and costs vary a lot according to the different situations. So there are some studies about origin food or geographical indication food, but to my knowledge, there are not many studies about short food supply chains or farmers market, etc. I know something about some experiences in Italy, in the farmers market in Rome, for example, but actually the evidence shows contradictory effects. So some are positive, and then depending on the indicators and the areas of analysis chosen, it can vary a lot. So yes, there is something. Especially on geographical indications, not many studies to my knowledge, but I'm asking you also if you know anything about short food supply chain branding in Europe or all over the world. To my knowledge, there are quite a few. Can you hear me? Yes. No. Yes.
Some of you have some interesting experience in assessing the effectiveness and the cost and benefit of these local branding initiatives, local brand, yes, initiative.
Well, I don't have an experience, and I think in robust context, it will be interesting to see these costs and benefits not only for stakeholders, but for the whole region, of course. Yeah. This is even more complex assessment than.
And I think that also Francesca worked on the theme some years ago. The microphone.
Sorry, I forgot to switch on the mic. Yes, I did my PhD thesis on the effectiveness of PDOs and PGIs for olive oils and the cheese sectors in Italy back in 2011. And I attempted to do a multi-criteria assessment based on a set of indicators covering different objectives. But as Andrea said, it's been a while. I haven't gone back on those themes. The evidence was not very conclusive, but one of the key messages was that this kind of certifications was very appropriate for products that have an international outlets and scope, but for the more local ones, very often it was more a cost than a benefit. So the issue is exactly how to make these tools more effective for the local context and more tailored to the needs of the smaller farmers as well.
And one of the problem is the access to the third-party certification formalized system. So small farms cannot easily access. They cost too much as compared to the benefit that could achieve, especially selling on local markets. Okay, okay. Are there other questions or remarks? Otherwise, I think we could move forward.
Okay, so. Allora, so yes, we have the presentation of three local initiatives in Lucca province, and in Pisa, there is a sub-province of Lucca. No, there is a big competition among Lucca and Pisa, because there are some historical reasons for this competition. So speak about Pisa as a part of Lucca is not so good for Andrea from Pisa. So the aim was to take issues and lessons from real life. So we have tried to answer to the three questions we present before to local representatives of three initiatives of short food chains in Lucca and Pisa. So the first one is Campagna Amica Farmer Market. Andrea is the author of this investigation, short interview. So, il filmato.
No, lo metterei dopo.
Dopo? La tua presentazione dov'è? So we have to find the presentation. La domanda è quella di media, quella vecchia. Ci pensavo. Questa qui. Abbozzato, pensavo dovesse qualcosa di più. Vai. Ok.
Allora, posso vedere.
Ora facciamo vedere. Ok. Okay.
And you will see it. Okay, so this first case study is about farmers market, and more in particular, a network of farmers market that has been created in Italy by Coldiretti, that is the logo you see on the top right of the screen. That is one of the three big farmers' union in Italy. And if we, Coldiretti is maybe the first farmers' union who catch the new trend of consumers towards local food and more in general, multifunctionality of agriculture, agritourism, agrobiodiversity, etc. And Coldiretti in 2008 founded a foundation, sorry for the double word, that is called Campagna Amica. It means friend countryside or something like that. And this foundation was specifically devoted, as we can read from the website that I translated here, was founded in 2008 to implement initiatives aimed at fully expressing the value and dignity of Italian agriculture, making clear its key role in protecting the environment, the territory, traditions, and culture of the health, food security, equity, access to food at a fair price, social aggregation, and work. So, in these 10, 12 years, this foundation launched a number of initiatives to enhance farmers' activity. So the focus was that of supporting their associates, so the farmers mainly, with the aim of increasing their added value and giving them more opportunities for diversifications towards multifunctionality. So what Campagna Amica, the foundation, did was basically, this is the list of the main areas of activity of this foundation, creating a network of farmers market, and that is exactly what we will show in a while, promoting agritourism, so agritouristic farms of their associates, again, promoting the marketing of farmers' products through restaurants and shops with the brand Campagna Amica, promoting also the products issued by agrobiodiversity. And here the foundation created a new brand that is called Sigilli, or the seals, I would say. Promoting in general made in Italy and typical products. So launching, for example, campaign against the fake made in Italy, like the Parmesan of Wisconsin or other horrible things like that. and urban agriculture and social farming. So turning specifically to farmers market, Campagna Amica created, a network of farmers market. Before moving on, I would like you to show the first video in order you can understand what is a farmers market under the umbrella brand of Campagna Amica. And it's a short clip, video clip, I recorded last week in Pisa, that is quite close to Lucca anyway. Just to give an idea, this is an indoor market where producers can sell their product directly to consumers. And as you see, the butcher or the breeder actually, and many vegetable producers. And it's quite crowded as a market. It's in the center of the city of Pisa. It's not a big city, 100,000 people, but it is quite growing as important. So maybe soon the market will have to move to find a bigger place.
It's open only on Saturday.
This is open each Saturday morning, but also they added two other days, the Tuesday and Thursday afternoon. So if you want to come shopping, you're welcome. So the fish, fresh fish, vegetable, cheese, meat, etc. This is to give you an idea, and fruit, of course. This is to give you an idea of what a farmer's market. They are not all the farmers market are indoor, so they can be in open air. And only farmers associated to the Farmers Union of Coldiretti and accredited by the Campagna Amica Foundation can participate and sell their product in the market.
This is the logo.
The logo, Campagna Amica Il Mercato, that you see on the top left, is the brand of the markets, of all the markets in Italy. And on the right side of the screen, you can see the numbers of farmers market in each region of Italy. I didn't make the sum, but you can see that there are quite a lot. So farmers have to register to the foundation. They have to pay some fee for each market they participate into. And they can sell at the farmers market, but also in the associated shops and restaurants I was saying before. So the main objective of this network at the beginning was rather to increase price paid to farmers, so increase their added value, avoiding the number of steps, the intermediate steps between farmers and consumers, and at the same time reduce the price consumers were paying for their supply. So it was there were really great expectations about short food supply chain, because cutting the number of steps that connect farmers to consumers and also reducing the physical distance, so the transport, the cost of transport and also storage of products, price to farmers were expected to increase and price to consumer decrease. And quite interesting, Coldiretti, this farmers union, was aiming both at increasing the price to farmers, but also to decrease price to consumers. So it was the first orientation towards consumption too. So not only benefiting the associated farmers and farms, but also helping consumers to buy food, and local food in particular, that were fresher and without too many pesticides, etc. And to reinforce this sort of mission towards consumers, prices of products in these markets are capped. So prices cannot exceed certain limits that are set each week by Coldiretti on the basis of prices collected in other marketing channels, such as local wholesale market, if available, or supermarkets of the area. So this is quite important because it shows both the mission of this network and more in general Campagna Amica Foundation, and underlines the attention, the new attention paid to consumers too. So turning specifically to the three themes of the introduction Giovanni made, so the meaning of local which are the rules and controls and how to guarantee consumers, I prepared three short videos. The first is about local, both for producers, and the second video for consumers. And I interviewed a fruit producer, actually a friend of mine.
Mercato dei produttori, Farmers Market. Siamo produttore Leonardo, siamo produttore di frutta, e volevamo chiedere a Leonardo qual è per lui il significato di locale.
Quindi questo contesto, diciamo, porta dei piccoli produttori che portano il prodotto e questo vento da un raggio di un po' di cinque. Quindi quello che consegue la stabilità e consegue anche qui la città di Mori, la città di Mori, di zona che vincono quando la stagione non consente di coltivare. E quindi per questo motivo sono sicuramente contenti, condotti in una maniera speciale, seguiti un po' in maniera tradizionale.
So as you have read more than listened, The meaning of local is quite, it's not just 0 miles or something like that, but the first thing he said is about my product or your product more in general.
Buongiorno Leonardo, siamo al mercato Campagna Amica con diretti.
Sorry, technical problems. So not just local provenience or number of kilometers run by the products, but also this sort of my product, my own product in on direct sale, and also what climate allows. So not industrial, traditional. So there are many meanings attached to the term local and not just the distance of the product. And then I asked him about consumers. Why do they prefer local products?
C'è una certa tendenza dei consumatori a chiedere, a cercare il prodotto locale. Secondo te qual è il motivo di questo interesse in crescita?
Credo che sia principalmente nel diversità del prodotto, nel sapore, nell'accesso, nella presenza, se si viene, si sente. Qualcuno ha anche fatto motivi etici perché la qualità locale va sostenuta. Minata dai grandi commerci, dai mercati globali, quindi oltre ad essere portato a fare attività rispetto alla terra, specialmente se si produce in maniera biologica, con l'ambiente, e quindi questo valore qui andrebbe sensibilizzato a tutti in questa maniera, limita la guarigione, limita l'incoraggiamento dei tempi.
So here again, the preference of consumers towards local products are more, I remind that Leonardo, the producer, the farmer, is a fruit producer. So diversity, taste, freshness, but also ethical reasons. So to support local economy in front of big players and globalization. And these are very important issues in the preference of consumers. Then turning to the second issue about rules and controls, let's see how the farmer replied. Thank you, Giovanni, for
questo mercato è fatto esclusivamente da produttori e qui c'è la regola che i produttori possono vendere solo i prodotti delle loro aziende senza commercializzare prodotti di altri. Quali sono le regole quindi di partecipazione dei produttori? E vengono fatti dei controlli? Come viene quindi garantita la provenienza o il fatto che i prodotti venduti siano locali ed esclusivamente dei produttori?
Allora, parlando di 100%, che è solo le campagne vita, da loro, da quanto le altre campagne vita, magari fanno tutti i limiti della quanto è consentita la legge di integrazione. È garantita perché la campagna vita fa i controlli uno oppure all'altro, quindi sia in comunità, in qualsiasi periodo dell'anno, o prima della maturazione, o durante. E questo con esclusioni o restrizioni nel caso in cui si sposano delle apparire sulla base della, sia della visita ma anche diretti a tutto il piano culturale dell'azienda, sulla idea che ci sono cose che degli altri sono tutte sentite, su cui fare del tutto e quindi non si scappa.
So the farmers market of Coldiretti set some rules and they make inspections to each year or in some cases twice a year to control the authenticity of the declarations of producers. And then I would add there is also an internal control between farmers. So if a farmer realizes that his colleague is cheating, he certainly will notify this happening to the supervisor of the market. And finally, as regards the guarantee, let's listen.
Che forme di garanzia hanno i consumatori? Come possono i consumatori essere sicuri che i prodotti sono locali, sono a volte rispettosi dell'ambiente e rispettano le regole del mercato Coldiretti a cui partecipano?
Allora, il consumatore già viene rispettoso perché il marchio la campagna vita poi c'è tutto il mondo che ascolta le critiche, ascolta diciamo anche gli apprezzamenti, si spiega e poi è il prodotto che fa, un prodotto magari irregolare, a volte ci può essere il prodotto del pacchetto che però viene apprezzato quando si basta su tutto. Quindi le varietà locali, le varietà che si trovano solo qui, queste sono la verità che è fondamentalmente una testimonianza della.
Quindi un marchio sui prodotti aiuterebbe o è più importante la fiducia e la faccia del produttore?
Allora io penso sia molto importante il rapporto. Quindi la vendita diretta direttamente col produttore che ascolta, che spiega. E il marchio sì, però ce ne sono ormai tanti, c'è un po' di frazioni di marchio, quindi ho paura che il marchio la sua loro.
Yeah, so as you have read, more than listened, it is very important to the direct relationship with the producers, but also in this case the reputation of the brand Campagna Amica Coldiretti, so the Farmers Union. So there are two kinds of guarantee, one of the organization of Coldiretti and the other may be more important in some cases is the direct relationship of trust, which comes from the repeated purchases by consumers. So these were the first case.
Yeah.
I don't know if there are any specific questions, otherwise I would make a general discussion after the presentation of the three cases. Maybe it's easier to compare and to add. I don't see anybody in this moment. Here, okay. maybe Sabrina could share.
Sorry.
Otherwise, we skip to the second case. Or if there are no specific questions on the farmers market call directive. Okay.
No questions. So, okay. The second case is quite different, quite but more specific. It's about Slow Food Lucca and this initiative about the signaling, but also the guarantee of these products of Slow Food Presidia. Massimo, you have a presentation or the video? How we go on? Massimo?
Yes.
You have a presentation or?
No, you can go with the presentation because I don't.
So we go with the.
If Andrea wants to speak about these cases.
So we can see the video, the short videos.
Yes.
The person interviewed is Marco Del Pistoia. Marco Del Pistoia is the responsible of the Presidia of Slow Food in Lucca. I don't know if all you know the Slow Food Presidia. You know the Slow Food Presidia or what is a presidium? Yes, okay. All? Or perhaps we can explain. No, it's okay. So Marco Del Pistoia is the responsible and they are now reflecting about the opportunity to promote a participatory guarantee systems in order to guarantee these two specific products are a bean, fagiolo rosso di Lucca, red bean in Lucca, e pomodoro canestrino, a tomato, canestrino tomato is another local biodiverse product in the plain, cultivated in the plain of Lucca. So, also in this case, we have three short videos. The first one is about the meaning of local.
Siamo qui con Marco Del Pistoia della cooperativa unitaria, nonché anche proprietario della Madossa Slow Food di Lucca. Lui è molto impegnato sul tema della valorizzazione delle produzioni locali, quindi la prima domanda che gli faccio è la seguente. In questi ultimi anni c'è un crescente interesse dei consumatori per i produttori locali. Tu hai lavorato molto per la difesa e il recupero di varietà locali, spesso in Lucca, creando due presidi, no? Il fagiolo rosso e il pomodoro canestrino. Quali sono, a tuo avviso, i criteri per definire un prodotto locale? E locale tutto ciò che può essere prodotto localmente? E quanto la varietà locale è importante nel definire il concetto di località e anche le tecniche produttive quanto sono importanti?
Diciamo che il locale tende più che altro all'interno, no?
Hello, I can't. Oh, are you aware that the sound has gone on the recording?
No, it's wrong. It's sonoro.
There is not more. I don't know why. We can try to. I don't know why. Because some.
It's not so important.
Yes. You understand Italian or not?
I
don't know. Sorry. This was the first one. So we go on with the second. We will try to we see se, if the sound.
Sto lavorando sull'applicazione di un sistema di certificazione partecipata per garantire prodotti depositi. Sapresti spiegare di che cosa si tratta? Okay, we. Un po' il discorso dell'importanza, no, della filiera corta, quindi della connessione tra il consumatore e i mercati contadini. Ecco, questo modello di certificazione partecipata che a questo punto vuole applicare sui presidi potrebbe essere utile anche per certificare i prodotti che gli agricoltori vendono sul mercato contadino, cioè quali possono essere degli elementi di positivi e negativi. Diciamo che finito questo, poi dopo
dobbiamo mettere al primo posto la provenienza e poi magari il processo formativo di un'università locale, una scienza tecnologica, comunque non conosci prodotti chimici, per esempio. Questo è il gruppo di politiche e insieme è stabilito le regole che sottostanno a questo processo. E poi il gruppo va a indagare quando sono prodotti. Quindi nel tema della società, questo strumento diciamo ci consente di utilizzare un paio di concetti. Ovviamente diciamo è molto meno semplice, no? Perché può apparire perché la base fondante quando può portare risultati è proprio la costituzione di un gruppo che deve essere.